Hey guys, I'm Ready Gamer 101, and today we're back on this NASCAR Heat 5 Championship mode. Here we are for race 14, and one of my favorite tracks, personally, Kansas Speedway. I love this track, of course. Last time we raced at Kansas, I forgot what I was going to say. Completely forgot what I was going to say. Oh yeah, last time we raced at Kansas, you guys saw that on my YouTube, or earlier, around like the first day, I think, Heat 5 came out. It was like the first... I think I filmed it the first day it came out, uploaded it like the second day, but yeah, anyways, I've taken actually a few days break from championship mode, even though I uploaded that Chicagoland race yesterday. I'd filmed that a few days before it uploaded, but yeah, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead, and I'll see you guys when we hit the track for qualifying. Alright guys, here we are, we're hitting the track for qualifying, so before I get into my little first announcement I want to make here, guess what? Yeah, I want you guys to guess what I'm gonna say. I'm gonna give you like 5 seconds, so better guess. Did you guess? You should have by now. Yay! The tire rim glitch, it still exists, it's still there. I know, so beautiful. So I fixed that in like a week and one day exactly. Into NASCAR Heat 5, like, excuse me, 704, you gonna fix your game? I know Eddie Benzi, the YouTuber, told me run the high lane here at Kansas, so I'm gonna try that today, and, you know, if the high lane's not working for us, we're also gonna run out of low lane. So, two dogleg tracks in a row, yay.
Let's see where that puts you.
Not the best. We're gonna start 19th. Hey, we've started back in the field in other races and gotten our way to the front to actually win, I think. I don't remember where we started at Homestead. I'm pretty sure we started like out of the top 20 and we still ended up winning that race, which was actually a pretty fun race. I thought I was gonna lose. Alright, so we start 19th. On the pole is Denny Hamlin. He won at Pocono, spoiler alert, and then he won... Oh, we get one more spot. I mean, it's not the inside lane, but... So he won at Pocono, and then he just won the last race at Chicagoland. So he's got two wins in a row. Cole Custer had that shocking win at Kentucky earlier this week, so... poor Kurt Busch, though. He failed the technical inspection. Hey, ugly tire rims! 704, will you fix your gosh darn game? All right, here we go. Green flag is out. We are now underway here at Kansas Speedway. We're going to run on board. Just start this one. So we got 9 laps here on the stage. We're going to move down to the inside to start. Oh, and we're really loose. Yikes, that was a bad corner, even though we actually held 18th somehow. We were really loose through that corner. So, that's fun. Hopefully you guys like this paint scheme, by the way. I like it. Here we go, we're gonna run the dog leg. How many spots are we gonna gain off the first lap? Looks like we're gonna gain 4 spots off that first lap. So we'll take it. Usually we're in an increasing rate on our positions off the first lap. Yeah, here we are. This race at Kansas. Like I said, I love Kansas. One of my favorite tracks to race at. And tracks of dog legs I enjoy so much. And my favorite, it's either Kansas or Las Vegas. I can't pick between them. I also like running at Phoenix, but it's not my favorite dog leg track. I run good at both of these tracks, I feel. I don't know, though. They're both very similar, except I think Kansas is just a little bit wider, like in track width. I think it's like wider on the turns and everything. I think the front, something makes me want to feel like the front stretch is just different in a way. Where like the dog leg is. Ooh, we accidentally get into Kozlowski there. Sorry, the man who got eaten by a shark in Sharknado, Brad Kozlowski, and the other NASCAR driver that was in Sharknado 3, Joey Logano over here. Man, I love that scene. Oh, heck no, gets eaten by a shark. Of course, that's not really what he says. He says, down there. No.
Five more laps.
If you don't know what that means, I don't know that. I'm not going to actually say it. Some people wouldn't consider it as a bad word, some people do, so I'm just not going to say it.
Still there.
And there's different ways they use it. I don't ever really use it, though, because I'm... Oh, come on, Truex! Of course, AI don't take the dog legs, so we're just going to take it ourselves in no draft. Jimmy Johnson trying to break a top five to end the stage. Or before the end of the stage. We're running a low lane, exactly the opposite of what Eddie Benzie said, but we'll probably run the high lane a little bit later. I don't know, we're going to try it this corner. I don't know if Truex is going to take it with us, but... Oh, yeah, and I was going to say an announcement in qualifying. Totally forgot what I was going to say. So my birthday is actually coming up in a week, and I'm excited as crap. Trying to crack ourselves a top five. Happy Meal Harvick. That's what Michael Moot says. But yeah, so some of the stuff I'm asking for my birthday, they could possibly be coming for a series of the channel, so I just want to say F1 2020, that might come to the channel. I'm asking for that for my birthday, hopefully. You know, we can get that and play a little bit of F1, you know, because I'm starting to get into F1 in IndyCar. The other one I do not want to announce. I don't know if I'm getting it or not, but if I get it, I'm not going to announce it. I'm not going to announce this thing I asked for. You're just going to have to wait until my birthday, for my birthday haul, I guess you could say. You're just going to have to wait, but I hope to surprise you with this. So yeah, you just got to wait. I'm not going to spoil it just yet. So, yeah. Jimmy Johnson.
Right,
we got a white flag in the stage. We're going to try to hold on to a top five. Jimmy Johnson seems to be much faster here. On the high lane, we really slowed ourselves down there. Hopefully, my boy MTJ can try to get us back up into the top five running for the stage. Denny Hamlin has dominated the past two races. We tried to get under Jimmy there. That would have been a top five stage finish. We're still going to try for the top five. We're not going to get it, though. Ugh. Last lap choke for us from just outside the top 10. But Denny Hamlin is on a hot streak as he wins another stage this year. You've got to be kidding me. Or another stage from past two races, two wins in a row. He's looking for a third win in a row. We can't let that happen. He's starting to become competition at this point. Oh, gosh. Even though he's, like, third in standings, I'm pretty sure. Truex Jr. is, like, fourth, I'm pretty sure. Or second right now. Hamlin is in third. So I'm going to assume he'll move up to second this race. So we're just going to have to run better than Denny and hope that fends us for a win here. Or just to keep out front in points. Of course, we really only need to finish top 16 in points.
Right.
I'd love to at least finish top 5 or maybe top 3 in points this year, though. Right now, like I said, we are in first. Or I don't even think that's what we were in first, did I? I'm not sure. We're going to make contact with Truex Jr. as we are now back to where we started this stage. Can't really figure out the corners. You're not running as well as I usually do here. We crack into a top five here. We're going to try to get up to fourth. Eric Almirola, he's running well this race. Does he usually run too well? I don't know. He's been running well in real life. He's definitely an underdog championship contender, I think, for this year. Here we go. One of my hottest rivals of the year, MTJ Martrex Jr. will work with us. We're going to slow it down to like 165-ish around there or something. We're not going to take the dog leg here. I'm just going to, you know, keep behind Truex Jr. Just let off gas. Bad call. I feel so tight right now. Because we're going to give up the fifth spot to Ryan Blaney, who had a shot at winning Homestead, and you know what? Go around.
Stay on the bottom here.
Not the biggest fan of the Penske cars. Only Penske driver I really like is Brad Keselowski. So we're going to turn my boy, or not my boy really, but we're going to turn. We're going to turn Ryan Blaney. I don't care if you're a Ryan Blaney fan. I still don't like him.
We're going green.
anyway. Blaney's my second favorite in Penske. He's really not even one of my favorite drivers. My favorite driver in Team Penske is Brad Keselowski. His favorite is Logano. Blaney and Logano find both of themselves on my top five least favorite driver list.
Because
Denny Hamlin, number five, got like Almirola fourth, Blaney third. Concentrating. Blaney's third up there. I can't remember who my second least favorite driver is. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. second, I forgot. And then my least favorite driver, of course, Joey Logano, if you don't know that by now. Dang, I just feel so tight right now. So Bowman is to the lead. He's got a win on the year at Michigan. We finished P2 at Michigan. I just realized we're almost to the end of the stage. Really does look like we're gonna be able to get a top five. Actually, don't underestimate the power of Chris Buescher. We make a little contact with my boy, Kyle Busch.
Careful, still there.
Oh, we're battling Kyle there right now for our fourth, not fifth. There's Chris Buescher coming up on us out of nowhere. Oh! Chris, come on. Okay, I can understand why you'd push Kyle instead of me, though, because I already have freaking five wins in the year. Looking for six at Kansas. I just felt so tight this race. Car's not running as loose as I would like. I don't know if my setup got messed up and I was accidentally on tight. We're trying to hold off a top five. We shove Buescher down the track. And Busch isn't going to be able to catch us. We're going to finish fourth in the stage. I'll take it. And Denny Hamlin wins stage two. I swear, if he just goes three races in a row with a win, I'm going to be so mad, you know. I hate Denny Hamlin. Don't like Denny Hamlin. So we got another outside lane restart. I would love to get a dog leg off the restart. But Bowman and Hamlin, each of them have a win. Of course, Denny with two, though. I'm just saying they each have at least one win on the air. Bowman with one at Michigan. Us with five at Vegas. Vegas Auto Club, Texas, Bristol, and Homestead. And we're trying to get six here at, I forgot to say, Denny's got his wins. Of course, I'll say it again. He's got his wins at Pocono and Chicagoland. Man, we could try to sweep the Kansas races. We're gonna try to do that right now. Of course, we got 11, 10 and a half laps, whatever you're gonna say. Yeah, pretty much like 10 and a half laps. I just realized somebody's on pit road. We have an opportunity at sweeping the Kansas races. We'll start with the first Kansas race, and then, of course, we'll see if we can get that second Kansas. We finished 10th last race for the top 10. After that just disappointing race at Pocono. Did not run well whatsoever at Pocono. Qualified like 18th and then just finished 23rd. Oh gosh, I didn't want to go up the track there. I accidentally did. We catch Kyle! Sorry, bro! Sorry! I just caught the inside of my man, Kyle Busch. actually caught the outside of Kyle Busch and got him a little bit of his tire and then just got him a little bit loose. Trying to catch Alex Bowman. Almirola looking for his first win of the season. Want to take the dog leg. Hopefully it gets us a little bit up here on Alex Bowman. Denny Hamlin searching for his third win in a row. I can't let that happen. I can't. When it was us winning three in a row, I thought we'd be the only driver to really go at least like two in a row. And then here comes Hamlin. Almirola, come on. And then now we got Hamlin. So he won two in a row. I'm like, wow, impressive. And now he's over here trying to get his third win in a row. I thought we'd be the only driver to really get three dubs in a row, but Hamlin wants it so bad. Hamlin wants that third one in a row to tie me for the most consecutive wins of the year. The most, I'm most confident about sweeping the Bristol races, of course. There's the one we raced in race 8, I think it was, where we swept that race. Denny Hamlin. I don't think anybody has swept a race this season except for me, and then Hamlin. He's also looking to sweep a race this year. Of course, he's got both stage wins in the bag so far. And now Denny Hamlin looking for the race win. Here comes, well, maybe Hamlin has swept the race. I'm not sure. I'll have to check back on the other videos, the last two. I don't know if he has or not. Here we go. We just can't really catch Bowman. We're having a little bit of a tough time getting up to him. Pull up the menu right here just to see if we're gaining at all and where we're losing, just to see. Okay, we're losing like right here. And then do we gain any here? It doesn't look like it. We gained 1,000 votes a second. Oh, and we fell back. Jimmy Johnson running top 5. It's good to see him running top 5. Come on. Oh, come on. All right, here we go. Now we're getting closer to Bowman here. Not wanting to lose any time. All right, we got draft now. Here we go. Yeah, we're gaining on Bowman now. Get over here. Trying to get our sixth win of the season. We've been probably the most dominant driver this season, but these last three races, including this one, of course, so three. Denny Hamlin has been the most dominant driver. He's going to try to hold the lead for three laps. We need a caution if we want to try to get this win at Kansas. We're going to cut below Bowman here. I wanted to put him in the wall, to be honest with you. I was going to try to get a caution out. We're going to need a caution this lap if we want a shot at winning. Especially a front row start would be nice. So here we go. Coming into the dog leg. Two laps to go. Come on. With a sixth place finish in stage one, and we got fourth in stage two. I don't think we're gonna be able to get a caution. I think Denny Hamlin's gonna get three in a row. No way Denny Hamlin goes back to back to back. Caution needs to come out like right now. Looking for a P2 finish here. We've had the most P2 finishes of every driver this year. White flag is out. Blow the tire, Denny! We're into the back of Almirola, going a little too fast through the corner. We're gonna not hit the wall though. Can we hold on to a P3? We don't really finish P3 actually. Really? We've just been finishing first and in second this year. Here we go. If Hamlin doesn't spin here, which he won't, coming out of turn 4, Denny Hamlin gets his third win in a row. Another top 5. And I thought we were, oh my gosh, I thought we were doing good when we won 3 in a row. Now here's Denny Hamlin sweeping a freaking race. Denny Hamlin just won his third race in a row. Wow, who finished last? I want to know who the guy down pit road was. No! You're Daytona winner. John Hunter Nemechek finished last. Then Michael McDowell, his teammate, finished or won at Talladega. He finished 23rd. Denny Hamlin, there's something about him. Look, how is he in second? How is he in second? This makes no sense. How is this man in second place? Oh gosh. Brady got hammered hard. Dang. Oh, dang. Kurt Busch got him. Anybody? Okay. Okay, I think I was ready. Denny Hamlin, how is this man in third place? I don't understand how he's in third place. Newman running inside top 16 on the points. Got that win at Richmond. Another win we could have had. We choked. Where are the Daytona and Talladega winners? McDowell running 30th on the year with that win. And Nemechek running 32nd with his win. Wow. Well, let's take a look at the like stat thing, and then I'm gonna end this video. So the fastest lap, is Denny Hamlin. Of course, he sweeps the race. He led only what? He led like every lap. On the move, it goes to Kurt Busch, started 39th. He still finished 20th. Tough break goes to Tyler Reddick, who started 10th, and he ended up finishing 32nd. That is a tough break. Well, anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed, and we finished third here at Kansas. Denny Hamlin gets his third win in a row. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.